Hello, I'm AJ DiMatteo, sales representative for McWane Ductile, covering Georgia and upstate South Carolina.
And I'm Ryan Terrell, product development manager. I work in our universal testing facility in Coshocton, Ohio, where we inspect, test, and develop our products.
Today, we will demonstrate one common way to cut a piece of ductile iron pipe. At some point during your pipeline installation, you will need to cut a pipe to a custom length. That may be for joining into a valve or fitting, or completing the lay link in a specific project area. There are several ways to cut a pipe, including rotary saws, chainsaws, and new technologies that put a safe distance between operator and machine. They can be gas or pneumatically powered, but most of you have probably seen or used a K12 style gas-powered rotary saw with an abrasive cutting wheel like this.
They're portable, easy to handle and maintain, and many crews have used them.
Ryan, before you fire up that saw and go tearing into that piece of pipe, I wanted to remind ductile iron pipe installers of one of the most important tools in the toolkit to save you time and effort in the trench, NOD tape. NOD tape is used for measuring the pipe's outside diameter. You use it to help select the right stick of pipe and decide where to cut it. Some of you may recognize the pipe markings we place on our pipe during the quality control process, and they can assist you in selecting the correct piece of pipe to cut. Check the description below for a link to our video on pipe markings. But it is critical to measure the OD of the pipe before making the cut.
That's a good tip, AJ. During manufacturing, the outside diameter may vary within a normal range along the length of a pipe.
All right, Ryan, do we have all our tools?
Yes, we do. I got our new 16-inch pipe here.
All right.
Today we'll be using a gas-powered K12 saw with a diamond tip blade. We have our OD tape, our paint marker, and our angle grinder to clean up the cut edge. And it's a good idea to have a fire extinguisher on hand.
We recommend cutting at least 2 feet from the face of the valve. But today, we'll be demonstrating a shortcut on the spigot end in order to rebevel the pipe and put it back to productive use. A 16-inch piece of pipe should have an OD of 17.32 to 17.45 inches. Selecting a pipe with an OD towards the minimum of that range may ease the installation process.
So now we're going to use our OD tape as a guide to mark our line on the pipe.
A straight cut begins with a straight line. Never eyeball your cut because it's too easy to drift from your mark.
We're good to cut.
Great.
Anyone working with or near the saw should wear the appropriate PPE. These are powerful machines, so read and understand the user manuals before you begin.
All right, here we go.
If working with an assistant, they need to be 45 degrees away from the saw to avoid being hit with flying debris. Cutting ductile iron is going to add time to your installation. We tell installers to allow for a minute of cutting time per inch of pipe. So cutting a 16-inch pipe like this should take about 16 minutes. If it was 24-inch, then 24 minutes. You get it. There are probably folks out there who think that estimate is a little long. But the point is to be safe, take your time, and let the saw do the work. Now that the pipe's been cut, you want to make sure to get off any loose iron. Use your angle grinder to remove any sharp edges and burrs. If you're making a mechanical joint connection, you can proceed with installing the pipe. A bevel, though, will be required if you're working with a Titan joint. We won't be demonstrating field beveling today, but we have another excellent video showing that process. Instead, we'll send this one back to the pipe shop so it can get a factory bevel put back on. So there you have it. This ductile iron pipe has been properly cut and is ready to be beveled and installed. That wasn't too bad. I'm glad we had our trusty OD tape to make sure everything measured up to spec. If you'd like more information about cutting pipe, I've written a blog that goes deeper into the process, and we have an easy to follow tip sheet that you can download and share with your team. Otherwise, you can reach out to me or your local McWane Ductile representative. We'd be happy to help you ensure your ductile iron pipe installation lasts iron strong for generations. Until next time, remember to work hard, Work smart and work safe.